Brother, can we just do the number 74? And as we come to that hymn, can we just stand and invite Brother Ashley to come? We'll sing that hymn, Lead Me, Lord, and I will follow. Lead me, Lord, and I will go. You have called me. I will answer. Lead me, Lord, and I will go. Amen.
Lead me, Lord, and I
that day. But that's all history now.
But I was privileged at that time to meet a man called Brother Beeler, spoken of in Surges this the time. And I've mentioned it many times, but there was one phenomenal thing he said to me. He said, "Brother Ashley, write it in your Bible. Put it on the flyleaf of your Bible. These words, spoken by the seventh angel, the rapture is a revelation." That was many, many years ago. I'm an old man now. I'm way over the threshold. But only now am I beginning to grasp the depth of that statement.
Amen.
The rapture is a revelation. Amen.
Yes, yes.
And he says, one day the bride will recognize her position.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes. Amen.
All right. Now, look at number one. Here we go. Oh my. If people in the message and around the world would only read this quote and take it all in, let's read it together. Number one, look what the seventh angel said. He said, "I hope you can read."
Amen.
I hope you can. Got a spirit of Christ enough to know what I'm talking about. The Holy Spirit reveal it to you. See? I remember when I was a little boy and I started going to school, they started to teach me how to read. And I can still remember the little book with a bus on the front page. And the first thing I learned was to identify one word, amen. And then as it went on, I was able to put two words together, a sentence, and then a paragraph, amen. And then I could read a page. And after that I could read the whole book.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
But you know, no matter how educated you are in reading, you can't read the Bible that way.
That's true.
Yeah, yeah.
Amen.
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 Amen. You've got to let the Holy Spirit, last week we said it, splice the thing together. And you have to go one step further, and that is read between the lines.
Oh, yeah.
And that's the way God trains His people. Amen. So number one is a great quote. And number two says, you'll never know it until it's revealed to you individually by the Holy Spirit.
Oh, yeah.
And then by accepting it, look at that. You become, amen, a new creature in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Born, amen, a second time.
Amen.
You got it?
Yes.
Amen. By accepting it, you become born again.
Amen.
Amen. You become a new creature.
Amen.
You become changed.
Yeah.
Watch that word now. That's what we're studying on. The word of the hour has transforming power.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yes.
And he said, you need the word to take the rapture with it.
Amen.
No substitutes.
Amen.
Your creed won't do it, brother.
True.
What your pastor tells you is not going to do it.
Yeah.
It's what the Holy Spirit tells you.
Amen.
Amen. Now look at number three. Here's where they make the deadly mistake. See, beautiful quotes here. Just as Sarah tried to bring the promise of the supernatural by a hand-picked Hagar, so has the church trying to bring a revival. Think on that. See, today, they fly message preachers all over the earth. This afternoon at 3 o'clock on one program, you can listen to a message preacher who constantly remarks on how he's traveled to over 140 different countries. Been around the world time after time. Printed many, many books. Lets them go free of charge. Ministers have pulled in millions and millions of dollars preaching this message. And they built beautiful tabernacles. They won't come to a hall like this where you've got sackcloth for a curtain. And an old pulpit that's falling apart. But they tried this way and that way and every way to bring about a revival. And listen, there's nothing but a dead thump out there. God has a way, brother. If you don't go that way, you die. Now look at number four. Number three. Just as Sarah tried to bring the promise of the supernatural by handpicked Sarah, so is the church trying to bring a revival. Number four. Now we find out here that these people that were trying to manufacture something. Hang on, Sarah, to help Abraham. Help God make his promise come true. You can't do that. Amen. Yeah, you can't do it. Now listen, sister, if you come to my church, I want to expect or inspect the way you dress. I want you to have your hair way down to your back. I don't want any shoulder pads. I don't want you to look like that. And don't wear high heel shoes. And don't, brother, you can't help God to get you to heaven. It lays in predestination. Amen. The woman in the well was a predestinated seed. Amen. She had a vile body and a holy heart.
Yes.
Amen. Right? You can't help God. There's only one thing you can do to receive God's promise, and that's believe. Amen. And let the Holy Spirit splice the word together for you.
Amen.
If you do that, everything else falls into line.
Yes, true.
Number five, look, there's no way at all of doing it. It's against everything. God's word's going to happen anyhow.
Yes.
You've just got to stand right on the word and say, it's this way. And keep the word.
Amen.
Amen. See, you've got to just look at this and say it's this way.
Amen.
Amen. You can't do anything else about it but only believe.
Yes.
You need to accept the word. Amen. That does it.
Yes.
Amen. All right. Now, number six. Abram just held on to God's word. He believed God. That's all he had to do. Now he didn't look to how impossible it was. He just accepted and took God at his word and went rejoicing over it. Can't you see why I'm so happy? Amen. I've accepted the word of the Lord.
Amen.
The revealed word that was spoken by the prophet of Malachi 4. Amen. Number seven. Oh, look at this one now. Number seven. Watch it. A revival is reviving what you've already got.
Yes, that's right.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
action, an act or instance of reviving, the state of being revived as renewed attention to or interest in something, a period of renewed religious interest. That's the interpretation. So revival is something that you've already got that is restored. Amen. Now number 8, watch. The first thing you've got to do is be born again. Get that next line? You've got to be
in shape.
Amen.
Amen. That's right, brother.
Amen. Uh-huh. That one go in. Did you get that, preacher? Amen. The first thing you've got to do is be born again. You've got to be changed.
You see?
And number 9, birth pains. Watch, watch, watch. They don't want to come out of it. They don't. They want to stay in the old system and claim the new birth or the message of the age. Amen? Brother, the message of the age will change. Amen. Oh, he says, I hope you can read. Amen. You've got enough spirit in you to understand what I'm talking about.
Yes.
All right. You're supposed to be rich, brother. Listen, number 10, birth pains again. They still try to hold to the old system and claim this, but the old system age must die. What? In order to bring forth the new one, they still want to cling. What's our text?
The body change.
Yes. See, brother, this old body that you live in has limitations.
Yes.
But when you receive that new body, you caught up in the mystery of the seven seals.
Yes, yes. Amen.
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 Number 11. How can you have a revival, a restoration? How can you have a revival of fresh manna on an old dead vulture carcass? How can you have it? A revival in our time. The revival will be so small they'll never know it ever happened.
Yes.
See that?
Yes.
Just a handful of people. Brother, you can't have a revival, a body change, a restoration on old maggot-blown denominational in the message dogma. Amen? Remember the eagle? Preached on the eagle. He had to decrust, amen.
Yes.
He had to get all his feathers plucked out. It was a traumatic experience to go through that change. And the body change is the same way. Nobody wants to see a new birth. Amen.
Yes.
It's a horrible thing. It's not nice to look at. People don't want to go near it. How many men have just absolutely passed out and fainted watching the birth? People don't want to go near it. It's nasty. But the message of the hour is also the same way. It has nasty components to it. This is the hour of judgment. Redemption is over. Nobody wants to look at that. Amen. Number 12. Look. 1961, prior to the opening of the seals. Look. God's going to condition Abram's children, getting them ready to receive. Watch that word. the promised son. How are we going to receive him? We can't receive him in these bodies. We're going to meet him in the air, praise God, forever. The trumpet shall sound and the dead in Christ shall rise, and we'll go up to meet him in the air.
Amen.
And how many preachers are preaching this day, this Sunday, throughout the world, crying out to their congregations, the coming of the Son of God is imminent. Soon, he's coming again.
Amen.
We're getting ready for the soon coming of Christ. Brother, sister, it's already happened.
Amen.
Amen. That's what we preach way down in Perth, Western Australia.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. All right, number 13. The next thing for the children of Abraham, the trumpet shall sound. The next thing. Oh, well, look, Brother Ashley, I'm Pastor so-and-so, and I have a great big tabernacle in the United States of America, and I've got a big tabernacle here in South Africa, and I've got a tabernacle over here. We believe that! We believe it! But do you believe the next thing I'm going to read? This is what the seventh angel said. Do you believe this, Pastor? No matter if he falls asleep in the first watch, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, or seventh, wherever he falls asleep, what will happen? Huh? The trumpet of God shall sound. Yes, we believe that. Let's carry on. The last trump will blast forth the same time that the last angel giving his message, and the last seal is opened. Last trumpet will sound, and the Redeemer come forth to take his redeemed possessions, his church blood washed. The last seal is open, brother.
Amen.
And the seventh angel has left the scene. And according to what he said, the last trump has sounded.
Yes.
So it brings us to number 14. It's a mystery that's to be revealed now in this day by the Son of Man. See, the evening message. See, turn back. Number 15, he says, the secret has been made known. The seals are open. Oh, he said, I hope you can read and have enough spirit to know what I'm talking about. Number 16, let's look at this carefully. Number 16, slowly. We've come here to enjoy a study together around the Word. Number 16. And we have not one other type. I have to type scriptures because I don't have an education enough to bring out the words and things. I make a type. Watch what he says. But if I see the shadows, if I never see my hand, and see the shadow, I know I have five fingers. Right? See, brother, can I say this in simplicity? A tree has only one shadow. Amen? Look what I'm watching. You know what this is? A mirror. If I take this mirror and I look at my nose is not missing. Amen. My loves, I can see them clearly. Everything that's on my face is mirrored in this mirror. Amen.
Yes.
Is that right? You haven't got one thing missing. Even the little hair on my head. It's there. If I look at it, it's mirrored. I remember last week we spoke about Jesus saying about the end time.
Yes.
It's the day of Sodom. Look at number 17. Read it carefully. And Jesus said that Sodom, hallelujah, was the foreshadow of the end time.
Yes, that's right.
Amen?
Amen.
Now watch. Oh, watch this quote. And the very, oh, look, scriptures that was promised to Sodom, the very scriptures that was taking place at Sodom that Jesus said would repeat itself again in this day. It's made known right before us today.
Yes.
Oh, did you read that carefully? The very scriptures that took place in Sodom takes place again at the end time.
Yes.
We were on Peltor yesterday and we were talking about the days of Sodom. And Brother Edward in Indonesia said, Brother Ashley, that's Genesis 18 and 19. That's right. That was the days of Sodom. But he said, what happened in the natural in that day happens in the spiritual in this day. Amen?
Amen.
The very scriptures, hallelujah, that were fulfilled then are fulfilled again today. No nose missing, brother. No mouth missing, sister. A complete foreshadow, Sodom then to Sodom now. So where are you going to put the body change? How dare you eliminate the body change in the shadow? Good question. But remember, it'll only come to that royal seat alone. The coming of Jesus will be so secret that the rest of the people will know nothing about it. Number 18. It's a sign of the end. That would be when these things happen. It'll be at the end time. And it'll be a sign now so that the elected, amen, will not be confused in these things.
Amen.
You see it.
Yes.
Amen. See, out of 7 billion people on the face of the earth, right now, there must be elected seed somewhere. Amen? Must be. There must be an elected, selected group called out by God and made known these things. You see it.
Amen.
They see it. Oh, brother. And the rest of them won't see it.
Right? Yes.
Number 19. Now elected. That's the kind that has their name on the book. From the foundation of life that believes, or the foundation of the world that believes all the word of life.
Yes.
That's the elected.
Amen.
Don't eliminate anything now. Don't eliminate anything out of the shadow now. You've got to believe A to Z.
Yes.
The elected are not confused on these things. Number 20. Like a thief in the night, he will come. He will catch the bride away and the rest. rest of them won't see it. Now underneath that, I've got something that he said. And if your eyesight isn't too good, you're better to read that. But I'll put it just after in a way that you can read. The very scriptures that was taking place at Sodom that Jesus said would repeat itself again in this day. Can you believe that? See, denominations won't believe it, brother. See, denominations won't accept these truths. Amen. That is true. But the royal seed of Abraham, that spiritual seed that comes on the earth in the end time, they believe every word of it.
Amen.
Oh. Amen.
Yes.
We see it all foreshadowed in Genesis 18 and 19. Look, number 21, Isaiah 60 verse 1. Rise and shine, for the light has come to you. That's the reason I can say shalom. The light has come to you. God's peace to the elected woman, to the elected lady, those who God before the foundation of the world called out and ordained to that. The rest of them will never see it. They'll never know nothing about it. The Bible said so. Jesus said, no man will come to me except the Father draws him first. And all that the Father has given me will come. See, many people regard me as a pastor. I don't regard myself as a pastor. I'm just a sinner saved by grace. Amen. See, but I think of myself as a pastor. Brother, I don't fit that pattern. I don't go running around having tea and cake with people and trying to pat them on the back and say, oh, come to church, come to church. That's what the pastors do. I'm a non-mixer. I'm way off to one side. I'm a lonely man and I want to stay that way. But brother, the Bible says, and God added to the church those that should be saved.
Amen.
You don't have to go and fish. You don't have to proselyte. You don't have to run here and run there. If people are elected seed and you preaching the word, they will come in here.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
For in the carcasses, there will the eagle be gathered.
Amen.
Yes. She. Amen. Oh my. Look, number 22. Okay, here we go. They profess they believe the word, but believing it in the way of their tradition and believing it the way God wrote it was two different things. Amen. Oh my. And brother, today there are two different churches.
Yes.
One natural and one spiritual. Number 23. God who made the promise in the last days, these things would happen that we see happen. If he promised a son and the son came, if he promised all these things that we see through the scripture and did it, let us get into the rhythm of it. Amen.
Yes.
He promised in the last days these things would take place. And we see it. Amen?
Yes.
What did he promise? He promised that he would send Jesus.
Yes.
He promised that he would send Jesus.
Amen.
He promised he would come again.
Amen.
In a cloud.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Look, the very scriptures that was taking place at Sodom that Jesus said would repeat itself again in this day.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Oh my, number 24. Look, read it carefully with me. Now we all know that when Jesus comes, be caught up in the rapture. And we know that our bodies will have to be changed second. Our bodies will have to be changed first.
Amen.
You can't go up in this body, you've got to go up in another body. Amen. Or take that quadrant, put it next to your bed and read it every night before you go to sleep. That's true. Look, 25. You're going to like this. It won't have to be just go back to a young man and woman. But it'll have to be changed. Because Abram and Sarah's body had to be changed. Are you reading now? Look, in a way that they could receive the promised son.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
Oh, brother, he said, wait. Every word. Is that right? Pull it out. Wait. Let's look at that word, receive. Let's look at deep. Let's look at it with spiritual eyes. I have Webster's reference library. The word receive, over here, I've got it. There it is there. 38 definitions of receive. Aha. I'm not going to read all 38 out, but I've taken a few out. What does the word receive mean? Look, you've got to be changed in order to receive, right? What does the word receive mean? One definition is, you've got to be changed in order to accept.
Yes.
Amen? You've got to be changed in order to meet.
That's another interpretation.
You've got to be changed to embrace. You've got to be changed in order to receive welcome.
Amen.
You've got to be changed in order to understand.
Yes. Amen.
You've got to be changed in order to believe.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
38 of them there if you want to go and look at the rest of them. Remember, brother, you've got to be changed in order to receive. Amen.
Yes.
The promised son. The very scriptures that was taking place in Sodom that Jesus said would repeat itself again in this day. Luke 17:30, even thus shall it be in the day when the Son of Man is revealed. Now our text. What's our text? The body change, right?
Yes.
Number 26, I heard, but now I see. That's Brother Branham's text in this message. He said, now Jesus promised here that in the last days, the Son of Man would be revealed, amen, to the same type of group, the royal seed of Abraham. It's a spiritual seed.
Yes.
And the church is looking for the promised Son. He will come right after the days of this ministry. He'll be revealed from heaven.
Amen.
Amen?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. And it can only be revealed to the spiritual body, not the natural body. I heard a tape this past week of a preacher in America. And he was challenging the belief that this cloud was a Thor rocket. And he said, when I went into it, my body was shaking, amen. He said, I spiritual things.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, yes. Hallelujah. Look, look, the very scriptures that was taking place in Sodom that Jesus said would repeat itself again. Yes. Now, number 27. Slowly. Let this one digest. Take this one in. Number 27. And we have Sodom in the natural. You know, the news bulletins are full of it. Last week I went home and there was that story on 60 Minutes about slip and all the corruption that's in the parlor. See, it's everywhere. Okay. And we have Sodom in the natural. Why can't we believe the sign in the spiritual?
Yeah.
Amen?
Yeah.
The churches don't want to go there because it means a new birth. Yeah. And it's best. Yeah. Okay, now. Last week we preached. Remember the message last week? They were running after the paper instead of the gift. Right? Okay? Or your likeness. Now, what was last Sunday? Father's Day. Right? And we went out for a meal. My little grandson come running up to me, the only present I got. And he said, yeah, I've got a present. And I took the present and I thought, wait a minute. That's all I preached on the whole day. The message is still lingering with me all the time. That's what I preached on. I better be careful how I handle this paper. I better look what's inside. I wonder if there's some spiritual application inside this gift. That's how you think if you're spiritual. Amen. And so he gave me the gift and I said thank you and I got home and I opened the gift. You know what it was? I'm going to show you. Interesting, right? Interesting. You say, well, how can you have a spiritual application of that? I looked at it, and I put it in my pocket, and I thought, no, I've got to look at it again. There's something about this. And I just went cold. Amen. Because here I have two bodies. Amen. And it's a puzzle, and you have to separate these two bodies. And it's hard. It's a puzzle. It's something that can take hours and hours to do, to get it separated. Some people say, oh, I give up, I can't do it. But the trick is to get it separated. And brother, that's the trick that the people don't want to look at. They don't want to separate the natural body from the spiritual body. Amen.
Amen.
And they struggle to do it. It's hard. It doesn't come easy. Oh, he speaks in parables. Amen. The bride of Christ is segregated from all the other bodies. So you can't be the bride and mix in denominations, brother. It doesn't work. You can't serve two masters. Either you love the one and hate the other, or vice versa. You've got to get separated. Amen. And he says, you are what? A twofold being connected. One to die, and the other to live.
Yeah. Amen.
Yeah. The one contacts the natural, the other one contacts the spiritual, and angels come to them and visit them and reveal things to them.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Why did they kill genre of art because she was spiritual. Amen.
That's right.
That's right. You've got to get it separated, brother. You've got to struggle to do it. But it can be done. Amen. All right. Prior to the seals, number 28. Remember, it's the last age that takes the rapture, right? Number 28. 1956. We're at the juncture of time to be changed again.
Hey.
You want that body change all the time?
Yes.
Right at the time! Oh my, he says, that makes me feel good. Yeah. Amen?
Yes.
It's time to be changed. Amen. In order to receive the Son.
Yeah, amen.
Oh, am I out of context? It's foreshadowed in the Word. The very hour we live in is foreshadowed in the Word. Brother, if you're walking in the natural realm, if you're trying to follow this message with the natural understanding, you're going to end up with this.
That's right.
But oh, if you're walking in the Spirit and you're allowing the Spirit to splice, oh my, put the Word together for you, you're going to come up with this.
Amen.
A mystery.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. It's true. It's true. You enjoying the message, right? Get it separated, brother! You'll never understand this message with the natural mind. You'll be religious. You'll go to church.
Amen.
Or you'll sing like angels. You'll dress like man. You're just something out of this world. But that's not it. He said that's the time that misses the rapture. They miss the body change.
Yes.
The body change is a revelation.
Amen.
The same thing he did with Sarah. He does with his church. And it, what's that body? It's a word-born body. And it materializes around the Word.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, yes. Number 29. Notice what happened immediately. She turned back to a lovely young woman showing in there, portraying what he's going to do to the royal seed of Abraham to receive the son that's been promised.
Amen.
We're at a junction of time to be changed again, right at the time. He said that prior to the seals. Brother, you have to pull the body change into the day and hour you were living in. Amen.
Yes.
Jesus said, as it was in Sodom. It's a mirrored image. All right, number 30. See, that's hard for people to get their head around because they've been taught so contrary by the denominations. They keep drifting back to what the denominations say. But he said, this message is going to be contrary to all of it. And they sure won't believe it.
Amen.
But the royal seed of Abraham will. Number 30. Now, God did something. Look where he goes now. Oh my. This is where they don't want to go. But brother, you have to go this way if you want the revelation.
Yes.
Now, he says, I'm going to have to get between the lines with you again.
Amen.
So you just think of it. You know what God did? What he did for Abram and Sarah, he will do for Abram's seed from then on. He showed right there what he's going to do for us. He changed them. Amen. He turned them back. He restored them back again. Like I said last week, he never said, Sarah, I'm going to give you another womb. He restored the old.
Yeah.
He never said, I'm going to give you a new heart. I'm going to restore your heart. Yeah. I'm going to take you back to the faith that was once delivered unto the saints. The apostolic doctrine will be implanted in you, and you will be able to behold the Son of God coming in glory.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
Number 32. Look. Number 31. Hold on. Now that's the next thing for the children of Abraham. The trumpet shall sound. The next thing. Look, listen. This is my wife. This past week. See, watch these spiritual things, brother. They're happening all around me all the time. Apply the spiritual application. Keep banging it. Keep banging it. And you'll come out with divine revelation. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Oh, my wife said to me, I've got to go get my ears checked. Right? And she went to the doctor. And the doctor gave her a syringe and tried to get some wax out of her ear. And she came back and she said, my hearing's perfect. Brother, listen, no matter how perfect your hearing is in this body, you will never hear the trumpets.
Mm. Yeah.
Amen. It doesn't come via this ear. It becomes a revelation to you via your spiritual ear.
Mm.
Oh, I hope you've got enough spirit in you to know what I'm talking about, he said. Are you grasping it?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
So watch those spiritual applications all the time. All right, number 32. He had to change her body in order to receive the promised son. And the next thing in order, the changing of the body, the rapture. When the rapture takes place, it will be a change.
Amen.
The church has been raptured.
Amen.
Amen. Number 33, he changed them in order to receive the promised son. Here we are right here today, waiting for the rapture. 1961, prior to the opening of the seals. Look, he promised to change his church, right? That he purchased with his own blood. Hallelujah. And not after the coming, before the coming. Change them in order to receive the coming. Hey. Alright. We're at a junction of time to be changed again. Right at the time. April the 6th, 1909. A mighty prophet was born among the Gentiles. Amen. And he had a major commission to introduce Christ a second time. Amen. Number 34, the trumpet of God shall sound. The last trump will blast forth at the same time the last angel is giving his message. And the last seal is open. That last trumpet will sound. And a Redeemer, amen, comes forth to take his redeemed possessions, plural.
Amen.
Plural. Huh? Not just one possession, possessions. His church blood washed.
Yes.
Oh my. See, the Son of God inherits all things. Amen. As Son of David, he's heir to the throne. Amen. As Son of Abraham, oh, listen to this one. He's heir to the royal rod. That's his land. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, Jerusalem, Jerusalem. Amen.
Yes.
That's his land. Belongs to the children of Abraham.
Yes.
And he's the son of Abraham. It's his man. He falls heir to it. Amen. The son of man, he's heir to the whole earth. He's the king of glory. He's our kinsman redeemer. Amen and amen. Number 35, are you reading with me? When the last seal is broke, and when the seventh angel's given his message, the last trumpet sound, and the dead in Christ shall rise. Yes. Amen. It's already happened, brother, and you knew it not. Sister, something has already taken place. Amen. And when the bride recognizes her position, she'll know who she really is. She's the royal seed of Abraham.
Yes.
Amen. See? So, oh, well, brother Ashley, I'm looking for a body change. Don't look in the future, brother. Look into the Word.
Yes.
Amen. Look into the mirrored image of Sodom. Amen. You'll find out if you believe that that was the coming of the Lord, you have been changed.
Amen.
Amen. You can detect it if you read between the lines.
Yes.
You can detect it if you allow the Holy Spirit to splice the Word together.
Yes.
For
amen.
You. Amen. Amen. I've got footnotes there, the last few I'm going to inject. Look. Now you want to learn ABC so you can study algebra later. Come on. When these other seals in the back is open, they'll only be revealed to him. That's right. Learn ABCs first. What is ABC? Always believe Christ.
Yes.
Not your creed. You see that?
Yes.
Christ. See?
Yeah.
Believe what he says, not what somebody else. I'm looking for the coming of the Lord. Look what Christ says in his word. He's already come and you knew it.
Yes.
Amen. Now what does this messenger of Malachi for to do? Restore back the original faith. Resurrection faith. Whoa. Amen. Amen. And the last one, brother, let me tell you, you've got to learn your ABC before you can get up any further. See, that's exactly right. To always believe that God's word is right.
Yeah, amen.
Amen. It was foreshadowed. Take that shadow and study it, sister.
Yes.
You'll find out what many people are looking for in the future has really taken place. God bless you. Amen.
Hallelujah.
And everybody said,
amen.
Oh. Amen.
Thank you, Brother Ashley.
Amen.
Can we just stand, brother? And turn with me to 264.
Hallelujah.
Let's sing the hymn, brother. We're going to call.
Yes, amen.
Hallelujah. Many times in my childhood when we traveled so far, by nightfall how weary I've grown. Father's arms would surround me so gently, it said, my child, we're going to call. Amen.
So gently, I'll sing.
again. And instead of saying that I'm going home, let's say we are going home.
Amen.
Let's sing it again.